A lot of comics do what they call relatable humor, observational humor, where people in the audience go, ah, yes, that has happened to me. Like, for instance, Jerry Seinfeld used it in that movie where he was a bee. You're the only crowd in the world that would laugh at that. You guys are perfect. So I want to try to do more of that kind of humor where people can say that happened to me instead of, oh, that happened to you. And I'd like to try one of those out on you now. The smokers particularly might relate to this. Have you ever been driving along in your car, smoking a cigarette, and you flick it out the window, and then you drive for a few miles, and you start to smell smoke, and you turn around, and you look in the back seat, and grandma is fingering herself? Surprise is a key element in humor, and none of you saw that punchline coming. You guys have been so nice. Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Keep it going for Doug Benson, ladies and gentlemen. It's 420 somewhere, bro, right? Huggin' bong, loody bong bong.
Bonus tracks. Have you ever been minding your own business downloading porn and someone sends you an instant message that comes up on your screen and blocks your porn? It's like blah, 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 ling. And it always says something like, are you working hard or hardly working? LOL. LOL, LOL. I hate LOL. LOL drives me crazy. Of course it means laughing out loud at computer talk. We all know that. And it makes sense if you're having a conversation over the internet and you say something funny, somebody writes back LOL to you. That's good, because it's, you know, it's acknowledgement that you just said something funny, because you cannot hear each other. But when someone writes LOL at the end of their own jackass sentence, like they could not foresee the punchline coming, hardly working, ROTLF down the stairs. DTS! When somebody does that, it makes me... So now I immediately write back to them, SMD. And they write back, what does SMD mean? I write back, suck my dick! LOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOLOL. Come on, I just Purell'd it up. It's probably a little too long before that callback came into play. I think it's a good thing that emotional scars are invisible. Because if emotional scars were visible, porn would be disgusting.